voice of our protagonist eventually win the cliffhanger, but the joy of winning the event is tampered with a demeaning, humiliating experience, an evidence of the stark reality of the oppressive caste system still prevalent in parts of India. The French attempt to move on in the unreasonable, absurd, caste-ridden, convoluted and sometimes violent world of adults, helped by the friendship and by the shared interest in anything naughty, pukish and mischievous. So this book is about the journey of these three friends, and in keeping with the theme of today, which is the closing ceremony of the Lit Fest along with the prize distribution function, I've chosen a one particular paragraph which talks about such an event in the book, or rather two paragraphs. Having won the first prize for our school, we waited with breathless eagerness for the short congratulatory speech from a host principal to be over. It was followed by another short speech from the chief guest, a high-ranking official in the education department. Next to go on the dais was a local politician. He began his prattle by promising the gathering that he won't stand for long between the winners and their trophies, and proceeded to speak for half an hour. And during his prolix, prosaic, prolonged speech, he repeated again and again, using long words, that he won't waste too much time on the congregation, making the talk all the more intolerably annoying and tiresome for all of us. We stifled yawns, held our chins in our hands, or stared at the ceiling or the moth-eaten carpet. Finally, after suffering the palaver for more than an hour, it was time for us to go up the dais and collect our prizes and our certificates. It was our moment of glory, our few seconds of fame. It was a morning we haven't forgotten till now. The certificate in the colors of a national flag is still with me, laminated, filed safely along with all the other certificates and valuable documents I've accumulated over the years. That was one experience that the boys had when they had participated in a quiz competition in the school. The next is again an award ceremony for the academic performance. We waited for the award ceremony, which was held 1 month after the results were declared, with pleasurable suspense and suppressed excitement. The ceremony was flawless, except the occasional cracking of the loudspeaker. As soon as I returned to the seat after receiving my prize, I opened the wrapper with pleasing anticipation. It was a dictionary. I was happy until I saw Vijay and Satvik's prizes. They were same as mine, dictionaries. The school had awarded dictionaries as prizes for academic excellence, irrespective of the standard or position in the class. I was appalled at the bureaucratic apathy and callousness of our teachers. To me, it was one more piece of the mounting evidence that the world of the adults around us was intensive, convoluted, paradoxical, and sardonic. And we friends helped each other in our boyish attempts to shield ourselves, to make sense out of the baffling, mystifying happenings in the grown-up world. We were each other's safety net in a chaotic world.